got Simon Fuller with me in the studio today from McColl's. Simon, good to see you. Welcome along.
Hello, good to meet you.
Many, of course, will be familiar with the name, familiar with the brand. But for those watching who perhaps might not be, give us a little introduction, Simon, if you would.
Of course. So McColl's has been around for a long time. Actually, 1901 is where the heritage of McColl's was. Back in Scotland, so Robert Smythe McColl, a footballer who started up a set of confectionery stores, effectively, near football stadiums. The business is very different today. In 2018, we're a convenience store business. We've got 1,600 stores in total, of which 80% of our stores are convenience stores. And we came to the main market in 2014 and listed. And really, that was an opportunity for us to continue to grow the business, to become more food focused, and that's really where we are today in that transformation of going from perhaps principally a newsagent business to really being a food focused convenience retailer. And we've got presence throughout the UK, from the sort of tip of Scotland all the way down to the sort of southwest of England.
Right, so that focus for you now firmly on convenience stores rather than the newsagents.
That's right. So when we listed in 2014, we said we wanted to get to 1,000 convenience stores. At the time, we had about 800 or so, in November 2016, we reached 1,000 convenience stores. We're now almost 1,300 convenience stores. So that has become a bigger and bigger proportion of our estate. With that comes a more favourable mix that convenience stores are. So we've become a higher proportion of our business is grocery, is alcohol, and all of the sort of top-up mission that you would expect to be had in a convenience store. So that's really what we want to be known for is a convenience-based business, and we've been making sort of big steps to change our focus.
In terms of funding the acquisitions of these stores, where's the cash from?
So when we floated in 2014, we, as we say, set out an ambition to grow our convenience store base, and principally we were buying individual stores,
right,
and we were paying for those out of our free cash flow as a business. We're a very cash generative business. We've got a fantastic reputation for managing working capital, and we've been very cash generative through our years. But we were buying sort of individual stores or small sets of stores across the UK. We weren't too worried about where they were, as long as they were a great store. So we weren't sort of trying to focus particularly on one county or one region. It was all across the UK. So that was sort of individual stores. We were buying about 60 a year.
Right.
The big shift for us was in 2016 when we bought 300 stores from the Co-op. And that was a really sizable acquisition. That was our biggest acquisition in the last sort of decade or so. And that really shifted the shape of the business. And I think that sort of has opened the doors to a lot more things that we've sort of implemented in our strategy subsequently.
And that Co-op acquisition, that was predominantly debt financing, was it?
Predominantly debt funded. It was an interesting year, 2016, because obviously the Brexit vote. We were talking about funding that acquisition at the same time where the UK population were deciding on the Brexit decision. So it's quite an interesting period, but we put in a small placing into the market of about 10% of our share capital, and at the same time we extended our banking group from 4 to 6,
right,
and increased our borrowings. But we were very comfortable to do that because of being such a cash generative business. We know that we can rapidly deleverage after the acquisition. And we were really confident that with the scale benefit that we got from this bigger business, that it was still the right strategic thing to do, irrespective of Brexit and any other things that were going on.
Most recently, 2017, a good year for you, revenue and profit both up?
Yep, so both revenue and profit up by about 20%, which is clearly a big step forward for us as a business. And that's only with the part year benefit of the acquisition.
Right.
Earnings were up significantly by over 10%. We increased our dividend slightly, which was good. We had really strong cash flows. So, for example, in working capital, we increased the inflow of working capital by £17 million. So, and that helped us to fund the things that we're doing in the business, like Project Refresh, like adding Subways, and perhaps we'll come on to that in a moment. But we're spending a fair amount of money to invest in the business to make it a better business.
You had some disruptions to trading at the start of this year. Talk us through those.
Yeah, so on the 28th of November, so just 2 days into our new financial year, we heard the very sorry and sad news that, Palmer and Harvey, who were one of our suppliers, failed. They serviced about 700 or so of our stores. And obviously that created a level of disruption in our supply chain. We're very fortunate that we've got some very supportive alternative supply partners. NYSA, who supplied other convenience stores, stepped in to help, and as did Morrisons, who we'd just signed up a recent supply chain contract with. They stepped in to help us as well. So it created a level of disruption, and in the build up to Christmas, and when obviously there's quite a lot of trade happening, it caused a little bit of short term disruption for the business. But in terms of the longer term direction, we're really confident that as we roll out more and more stores to the Morrisons contract, this will resolve those sort of shorter term issues and give us a really solid and long term partnership with a very stable player.
Under the Morrisons contract, how do those costs compare to Palmer and Harvey's?
Yeah, so Morrisons ultimately will replace both Palmer and Harvey and NYSA. So all of our supply chain partners. So in terms of if you go into one of our convenience stores, Morrisons will end up supplying own branded product, which will be through the Safeway brand, which we're very excited to launch back into the UK. But they will also supply soft drinks and confectionery and alcohol and other food products, so packaged food. You'll be unsurprised to hear that one of the things that we were looking to do through changing our supply was to improve our commercial terms. But it wasn't just about that. So really, it's three things that we wanted to do with our change of supply chain contract: improve our commercial terms, improve the customer offer through a better fresh range, so better meat products, better fruit and vegetables, etc. But we also then wanted a stable partner, and we knew that that wholesale as an area has been under a lot of pressure. The margins are quite thin, and it's well known that a number of the players had their challenges. So we felt that Morrisons ticked the box on all of those three: a really stable partner, a really great fresh food offer, and also with the buying power of a FTSE 100 company, mm-hmm. Which is something that we hadn't been allied to in the past.
And as far as this contract's concerned, a 12-month contract?
It's actually a longer-term contract. Right. It's a six-year contract. Oh, good. And across those 6 years, it's worth sort of multi-billions of pounds of sort of wholesale revenues, if you like, for Morrisons. It's a long-term contract because we're seeing it as a partnership. And in fact, that's the word that we tend to use when we're talking about it. It's a partnership because both parties have a lot to gain, we feel. We have access, as we said, to a brilliant fresh food offer, supermarket quality products, which is something that is going to really sort of step us forward in terms of the customer. And then Morrisons are looking to sort of grow their wholesale business. So they've been quite public about they've got a vertically integrated business. They've got their own farms and factories and fisheries and so on. And they want to get those assets working efficiently, which means the more supply, the better. By supplying us with Safeway product that will run off the same production lines as Morrisons product, they're obviously going to become a more efficient operator. So there's a lot to benefit for both parties, and we're really excited about working with Morrisons, who we feel are a fantastic team to work with.
Well, it certainly sounds as though 2018 is shaping up to be quite a strategically important year for you.
Yeah, we've had some big years since we floated. I mean, 2014, I think, was a seminal moment for us in terms of floating, giving us access to flows in terms of capital and support and access to the market. And we've built on that through investing in the business, through the big acquisition, and now through our new supply contract. And if I was to sort of summarise down sort of what 2018 is for us, it's rolling out the supply chain contract. So we'll have about 80% of our estate will roll out in 2018 to Morrison Safeway product. And then we will also be continuing with our refresh program. So this was the other piece of the sort of puzzle for us, if you like. We've been adding a lot of new stores. We talked about buying single stores and then this bigger tranche of stores. But what we also wanted to do was make sure we had organic growth in our existing estate. So we're in a process now of refreshing our stores, We're going to do about 100 this year. And that will be going into perhaps a store that hasn't seen capital investment for maybe 10 years. And it will be putting in new refrigeration. It will be perhaps relaying the floor, changing the counter design, putting in more food to go. Really fundamentally shifting the category mix to being more food, more focused on sort of modern day shopper missions. We've done about 26, 27 of those in the prior year. And we were seeing a 5 to 10% like-for-like uplift. So we're super excited about what that can bring to us.
What kind of capex are you looking at for that?
It's about £70,000 to £80,000. I mean, relatively small stores. I mean, our average convenience store size is about 1,800 square foot. So it's quite intense. I mean, we're sort of trying to squeeze a lot into a relatively small box. But yeah, I mean, the principal part of that investment is refrigeration, because we see that the future is about us being a bigger fresh food business. And so we put in a lot of refrigeration, and it's sort of all sort of modern looking and energy efficient LED lighting. It mm-hmm. really gives people a lot of confidence that the food they're buying has been well looked after, has been kept in good condition. And that allied with then the Safeway brand will be great product merchandised in a really good way that will make people, I think, very confident about buying food from our business. So I think we're really, that's the big transformation for us now, to go from, as we said, a sort of perhaps a newsagent business to a convenience business to a food business. That's really the sort of the next stage of our evolution.
And you were mentioning a moment ago about some of the pressures the industry's in. You've performed pretty well over the last couple of years, given those downward pressures. You must be pleased.
Yeah, I mean, we're not complacent, because retail is a tough sector, and there's been some high profile names in the press over the last weeks that have proven that it's that retail is competitive, very competitive. I mean, what gives us sort of reassurance is what the IGD, so the Institute of Grocery Distribution, are saying about how convenience is going to grow in the future. So they've said in the next 5 years, they expect compound growth of 3.3% per year. They think there's going to be an extra 7 billion of products sold through convenience channels in 5 years compared to now. So we're in a growing part of the market. And if you look at the cyclical trends, it tends to be convenience stores are slightly more immune. Smaller basket sizes, our average basket is sort of 550, 560. We tend to be a bit more resilient to the ups and the downs in the market than perhaps more discretionary spend or sort of more luxury items. We tend to be little and often shopping. In a way, actually, people perhaps see that as a way of sort of managing their budget, because they go to their local shop. They know they're not going to waste a lot of product because they can come in and out as they need it. And so in a way, you could sort of argue that we're sort of almost counter-cyclical.
You pretty much made the case already. I was going to leave it the final word to you. Just a couple of points for investors, potential investors watching this. Why should they take a look at McColl's?
Well, I think we're a great business in transformation. We're, as I've said to you, we're a cash generative business. We're a business with a very clear strategy of who we want to be. We've got some great partnerships. I've mentioned Morrison's, but we also have partnerships with the post office. We've got 600 post offices in our stores. We've got a great partnership with Subway. We've got 20 Subways in our stores. So we've got some really fantastic partnerships. I'd say that the next 3, 5, 7 years, we are still seeing growth in the channel we're in, and we want to latch into that. We're a neighbourhood player, so the people who shop with us live local to our stores. So we've got a very sticky customer base. So something like 60% of the people who shop with us live or work within 400 metres of the door of our convenience store. So I'd say we've got really clear identity in the neighbourhoods we operate in, and a really clear strategy for future growth. And that's probably where I'd leave it, which is we've got three things we want to do for our strategy for growth, and that is continue to acquire stores, and we've got a plan to do that over the coming years. We want to refresh our estate, as I've said, to drive organic growth. And we really want to improve our offer through the Morrison's deal. And I think those three together are very compelling as a growth story.
Very nicely put. Simon, good to meet you. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much. Cheers.